The administration is proposing a new 42% tax on the daily gross of gaming revenue from electronic gaming machines that involve an element of skill, i.e. skill games. Now, as much as I welcome economic opportunities, specifically for small businesses that are utilizing these gaming terminals, not every community is happy to see them flooding our local businesses. So in the city of Philadelphia, there has been a skill game company that reported making $60 million in revenue with these terminals, with 40% of those terminals being in Philadelphia County. So as you make your projections around taxing skill games, how are you assessing the ability for us to remove the skill games that exist already in the Commonwealth and then essentially reissuing and then taxing? And essentially the question is, how are we removing some of those skill games that exist in the city of Philadelphia that are becoming burdensome, that are becoming burdensome to some neighborhoods, but also not to, you know, take away from the economic opportunity. So how are you managing and balancing those two perspectives?
Right now, this is a proposal that the governor has advanced, something that in relation to gaming, we believe is important because currently that gaming activity is being discussed primarily in the courts and not where we believe it should be, and that is in the policy-making arm of state government. How many machines are going to be regulated, where taverns, restaurants, convenience stores, how much we're going to be charging for licenses and renewals is a matter for conversation by this assembly. But we believe what the governor has advanced is as legislative work products are a work in progress, and it's a starting point. And from that starting point, we hope that we can come to a platform that regulates this activity where it should be regulated, and that's within the confines of the policymaking arm of state government. And speaking for the Department of Revenue, this activity that hopefully the Assembly and the Governor can engage in is going to be very important in the long-term self-sufficiency of the lottery. If we don't do anything in regards to the expansion of gaming that's unregulated in the Commonwealth, the lottery will suffer. And it's very important as a matter of context for us to keep in mind that right now, when you consider when I started the Assembly, the things that were legal were horse racing and the lottery. 2024, Pennsylvania, in terms of gross gaming activity, is the number one state in the country. Many people would probably believe it's Nevada, but it's not. It's Pennsylvania. And if we're not going to sacrifice the things we've already made legal and things we depend on for services to our constituents, we can't have a large gaming activity out there that's not regulated. So we look forward to Representative working with you to make sure that all those issues, specifically the issues relating to the safety of communities, is considered when we do this.
Thank you.